Okay, how do we get out of here? I always forget how to get out of here. It's this way, right? Yep, there we go. Okay, so now I've got a fair amount of levels, now I've got a fair amount of power. Now everything should be going my way. Oh, right, I got some blunt sword. Blunt swords along the way here. Because that could be really useful. Let's check. Because getting a whole set of blunt weapons, blunt swords would be kind of amazing. Okay, so there's one blunt, there's two blunt. Yeah, blunt. So we've got, double-edged swords, 5. Rare, also blunt. And blunt. Unfortunately, we've got these two lances that don't really fit. I like it how I'm just, like, all sword time here. Okay, well, this is fine. We've saved. Oops. Honestly, nah, we'll probably be fine with the lances. We should be able to just, like, clobber our way through all of those, like, hard-to-hit enemies this time around without, like, really running into many issues. Okay. Yeah, I love the whole, like, blunt, piercing, slashing magic situation. But still. Yeah, oops, spoilers. Only up to the Boob Talk episode on YouTube. Yeah, that's a little bit behind. You're probably not gonna miss much, but still spoilers. That's the one unfortunate part about playing, like, plot-y games. Okay, this guy is harmable by everything that's hardly effective, but does a fair amount of damage to him. So I guess this works out pretty well. Okay. Okay, so this sucks. Oh, you know what? I just realized. Yeah, the lances are awful. What I can do with this one is... I don't want to do that. I want to do this. There we go. Okay, so now we start with three swings of a stone sword, which should take out most of these guys, no problem. There we go, especially because I believe I boosted one of them really heavily. Where am I going? I have no idea. Alright, whatever. At least this is going to get a hell of a lot easier than last time. I should probably figure out what those 100-day rolls do. Here, let's check. Energy snack. Oh, restores gigacals by... Yeah, those would have been incredibly useful. Cookies, 100-day roll. Should probably use them, honestly. I should probably buy more of them, too. Okay. Oh, lots of new people popping up tonight. Yeah, welcome to the stream. / YouTube, because this goes up on both. Okay, oh, right, don't sprint. This is a bad move. So we wanted to find the golem back the other way. Oh, that's where I am. I was actually trying to figure out exactly where I had left off after last time. And we are asleep. There's gotta be a better way to wake him up. Come on. What button does it? There we go. Should almost be like a quick time event. Wake 100 Knight back up or something. Okay, well, we got a mysterious dark fragment. Oh, we got a new Tochka. Neat. Did I just, like, ignore that the last time through? I was coming through? There's a very real possibility. Okay. And what else do we get? Another 100-day roll, which we can't use. As neat that they're there, I should come back and collect them, honestly. Yeah, those lances are precious. Maybe I should see if I have any more of the spear things to work with. Oh, well. Let's put that down for a second. Let's grab that, just because it gives me a little bit of grade. But we've got that well there, which I kind of want to check out. We've also got these two treasure chests, which we might as well pop open. Blue stone, weed gum. Oh, right. I should sell all that loot and see if I can buy, actually, I have no idea what I'd buy. Maybe more blunt swords if they have them. And looks like the well is impassable. I guess it makes sense. This game is not... Does not actually have jumping and stuff. This game would actually be kind of nice if there's jump and you could do, like, air attacks as well. Oh, somebody respawned, I realize. Well, this is going to go poorly. Alternatively, it'll go great. Okay. Because we can just kind of clobber-knot our way through most of these things. I think he got stuck in there behind the key. Alright. Well, that's easy enough. And that should work. Perfect. So we've got a pillar up ahead. We might as well kill a couple more of these guys. No, the pillar is back behind. You know what? I could probably make do without. We grounded enough. Exit. Proceed to the world map. Oh, what? You mean I was literally at the end when I left this area earlier? Wow. Well, all right. I guess that works. Did not intend for that to happen. Okay, so are these both Tatara deserts? Tatara area, Tatara. Oh, wait, no. Yeah, I was looking at the wrong thing. There's region, and then there's, like, area name. It's bad. I don't know. It's bad user interface, almost. Because it doesn't really matter what area I'm in. Like, who cares if it's Tatara area one way or another? Because ultimately, ultimately, I only care about the area name and nothing else. Oh well. So let's see. We can have story, or is it immediately just gonna chuck me into combat? Well, not combat, but immediately chucks me into fighting things. Because I got those blunt swords, though, I can just totally roll these guys. That'll make my life a lot easier. Let's see what's up ahead. Oh, it's a passed out Wigglywomp. What? Is someone dying? Shepherd. Dot, dot, dot. Ugh, who's there? Huh? He's still breathing. Well, whatever. Let's go. No, wait. Ask him where the bell plant is. Show him the letter. What's this? Bell plant? That's... Huh? Sounds like he knows. Make him spit it out. Water. Ugh, fine. We don't have any other clues, so get this helpless, sad sack some water. I do not have. Hey, find some water. Well, that's glorious. So now we gotta find an oasis out in the middle of pretty much nowhere. Oh well. So I should really look up how expensive 100 day rolls are, because if I can buy them, I'm gonna start getting a lot more aggressive about exploration and whatnot along the way here. Because if I can just open things up. And, like, if I can explore an entire area in one go, then we can get, like, massive, you know, damage boost, stat boost, whatever, while we clear. And then just, you know, chug 100 day rolls if needed. It's probably super inefficient. Oh, he died. There we go. Yeah, that second sword swing does a ton of damage. I think that's the sword that I boosted up really heavily. Okay, so this is... Oh. Should be able to open this one up easily. Okay, nope, that's items. Tochka! Time bomb. There we go. And... Nope. Oh, that's the wrong side. I honestly do not remember which of these Tochkas... are like, usable. Or not which of these Tochkas are usable. Which of these items, or what button combo is Tochka, and which button combo is, go into berserk mode and screw yourself out of, continuing exploration. Oh, been scared to death. Weird. I guess they will actually, like, lose HP and die. From fear. Fascinating. Yeah, also died of fright. Okay. Music for this area is kind of pleasant. Reminds me of, music from Tales of Symphonia, interestingly enough. There we go. I have no idea what you're supposed to do when you're asleep. I just press all buttons, and that's just the end of it. Okay, yeah, watch. Well, we found a pillar. Oh, this place could sell water. Let's try talking to this person. Oh ho, travelers in a place like this. Do you plan to climb Mount Asbroken? If you head west, you will find the mountain range, but you should avoid it. Some call the place a holy land for witches. Witches are bad news. Stay away. All right. I'll, Sand Eater Hater. What? So what is this place? I might be able to get water here. We're kicked out by residents. Unfortunately, this cost me a fair amount of decals. However, I gain no karma for raiding houses like this. I'm a terrible person, but it's important. Actually, don't think I needed to even what? They kicked me out? Oh, they're level 29. Yeah, I guess we're not opening that one up for a while. Well, let's just switch back. We are not having a good day here. Distribute grade points. I guess G-Cal recovery. Yeah, we're not fighting a whole lot of things. It's just like, well, go find water. Oh, this is the end of the area. So this must be how you get to the mountain. Which is not super useful for what we're doing. Probably means I'm in a wholly wrong area. And I should probably go elsewhere. Oh well, exploration's fun. Worst comes to worst, we head back to that pillar and leave. It's not like we have a whole lot of grade or are using it. So I'm just gonna look around. Let's see what we can get. Because it doesn't seem like anything particularly story-based is happening for at least a little while. So we can just kind of... make this work for the time being? I don't know. Pop in and out, spend as much time as we need. Though ideally, I'd like to do I'd like to do this sort of thing off-camera. These guys... That was ineffective. Okay, they're like weird sheep critters. And they're very weak to slashing. Well, somebody did not read the manual on the Wanderbot, because the Wanderbot likes hitting things with slashing weapons. Everything else, meh. Oh. I just realized these are considered neutral dudes. What happens when I run out of giga calories? I more or less start starving to death and have to leave the area. And if I don't, I die, and then I have to do the whole area again. Mostly. I think my progress is still considered. It's just the rest of it. Not so much so. Yeah, so those were effectively, like, crazy sheep. And, the sheep are considered neutral creatures, but as long as I've got the, jester facet running, we don't have to worry about a thing. Okay, gotta not do that. These lances are awful. But as long as I have the jester facet running, we don't have to worry about getting karma, so I can just kill like random beasts and stuff. I believe. Also, we have enough anima that I can just get rid of it anytime it happens. I'm an upjack. Yay. Considering how few enemies there are in this area, it might not actually be a bad idea for me to eat one or two of them. Damn it. The only problem is, they die too fast. Like, literally actually die too fast. I might be too strong for my own good. That didn't work. Yeah, they keep dying of fear, because I think I overleveled them too much. On top of everything else. Okay, there's one that we can eat. These guys are not that nutritious. That's only 8%. That's pretty bad. But that means I can eat a bunch of them. If I can manage to do so. If I can eat this snail. Snail might be actually worth a little bit more. Snail is also not that nutritious, but more nutritious than those egg things. Okay, so that leaves me with a fair amount of junk, but now at least we have a little bit of exploration we can do, and I've got a pillar up ahead. There it is. So if I want to leave the area, I can totally do so. So I think I'm just gonna use all of my grade points for a G-Cal recovery. We might as well stick around as long as we can. Because at this point, I already do enough damage to just, like, insta-get most enemies. We got a village up ahead. Maybe they have water. Oh, you want some water? Get a bottle from a merchant, dummy. Don't think badly of us. We simply don't have the luxury to care for others here. Don't cause too much trouble. The sand eater makes its home nearby. The larger ones consume entire villages, or so I've heard. Be careful out there. Alright, so this is a house. Probably house, and farmhouse. Decent odds. Get out of my way. Well, whatever, I'll just raid them anyway. Needs to be a chef fastest so you get more G-cals from those things. That'd be kind of neat. Yeah. Okay. So let's see if raiding this section would get me anything. Oh, we just get some mana. I don't think this is the place to get the water. I think we gotta keep looking. There's no verticality in it. Is there? I think there's a Oh, right, you gotta take the jump points to get up top. I was wondering about that, but that's like the only... That's the only logical conclusion here. Oh, he died of fright. Like everything else in this game, I've noticed. Almost all of my enemies, like, bite me and then die of fright. They're like, ah, oh no! Death! Death comes! Why? I don't know, it's kind of goofy that they like managed to get that parting blow in and then immediately die of fright. Oh, well, at least it gets me extra experience, which is kind of nice. Not a merchant in sight though. Bit unfortunate. At least my weapons are leveling up. Like, that's really good. I must have gotten hit by the other one. Okay, whoa! I did not realize that, but the like champion dudes. Thought I heard a pillar for a second. The champion dudes are actually worth like a fair amount of experience. Like, five times as much. Good to know. Not like you can really go out of your way to hunt them or anything, but still. Okay, let's grab that anima. This is the height of interest. Wandering around in a desert looking for things to do. Oh, there's another game that you kind of did that in. And I honestly can't remember what it was called. I feel like a lot of RPGs with the old open world system had pretty boring, just like wander around the open world looking for places to go. I had that problem with Final Fantasy VI, actually, whenever it became like super open world. It's like, you have nothing to do. Congrats! We're going to give you like zero directions. You honestly think I could just, like, walk back... I've gotten in this, like, awkward circle. And it's not doing me any good here. Journey. Yeah, but, like, with... Journey... Nope, still don't have it. Damn it. Don't make me run through this a second time if I don't have any. Journey. Yeah, but like, Journey felt like there was a goal, and like, the moving around felt really good. And like, calling Journey just aimlessly wandering around the desert is kind of does the game disservice. I really want to play that game again. Problem is, I've already done a series for it on YouTube, so it's like, okay, let's run back to the pillar. I don't have a lot of grade points, so we'll just pop back to the world map and then come back. Keep exploring. Though, it might be worthwhile to try to go back to the, let's return to base and see if I can buy a, if I can buy myself a bottle of water there. That'd be interesting, if that's it. Okay. Personally like the Wandering and the Dot Hack series. I never actually played them. I had a friend that was like super into the Dot Hack series, like obsessively so, and he kept telling me to get Dot Hack and Final Fantasy. Necessarily comparable, but like he was really into, we need to play an MMO together thing, and you know, me being what, like 12, 13? Wasn't exactly having it, but I never got into them, and like, I wouldn't mind playing them at some point. I tried playing one for a bit, and it just seemed like a lot of talk, random dungeon talk stuff. Okay, so we've got, yeah, go figure. We aren't gonna run into that sort of thing. AP recovery item. It doesn't look like it can buy buns of any variety here. Just these. Okay, so I want to try something. Sell. We've gone. Miscellaneous. So these are all just worth money, right? So this lets me sell all of my, like, loot in bulk. Okay, let's start doing that. Wondering how I was gonna make more money in this game. This is how you do it. Okay. We sell all of this junk, except for the Fool's Rock. We can't use that, or we can't sell that. That would be a bad move. Do we have anything else here? All right. Luckily, you can bulk sell all the garbage really easily. Interesting. The garbage is actually worth money. It's like combining a roguelike and an RPG in 3D. The story had a lot of hidden depth. Huh. Like, I actually would not mind playing them. That's just one of those that goes really low on the bucket list of games to play, just because I've got so many other, like, not so slow. Okay. So this is South Tatara Desert. Oh. Apparently, I had to go back to the previous area to buy the bottle of water. Who'd have thought? Either that or it's lying to me. There we go. But yeah, I don't know. JRPGs are intrinsically long, and I'd love to play them all. I'd love to play, like, a lot of, like, really good, deep stories and whatnot. It's just a matter of, like, can you fit all of that into one YouTube career? And maybe. Maybe if I try really hard and people, like, actually watch, but still... Yeah, there it is. Wow, so I was just wandering around in the previous area and all I had to do was go elsewhere. That's a little annoying. Oh well. Yeah, no, I don't know, there are a lot of like really good PS2 era games that I just never got into for mysterious reasons. I say mysterious just because it's like, I heard about them, I wanted to try them. But I just never got around to it. Thunder Knight feels water. This is your chance to obtain water. This place is mildly damp. Oh, hey, so I can just... Nope. Which one of these is a merchant? Get out of the way, Professor. Jar cellar. Ah, treasure water jar. Let's try and visit. I assume they're just gonna kick me out. Yep. Okay, kicked out by the residents. You're a jar seller. Alright, Mr. Jar Seller. I guess I'm just gonna witch dominate this entire village because I'm a terrible person. Okay, so we get the water jar and witch domination. I kinda wish they had put more time into the witch domination mechanic in this game. It feels a little limited. Maybe there's more to it, but still. I've been trained. Some experience. I guess. Okay. But yeah, no, there's too many other, like, JRPGs that I really want to play through. And, like, I'm really hoping that, over the course of, you know, the next year, the channel gets large enough that I can do these things. Like, you know, last episode session, whatever, we're talking about, you know, Breath of Fire 3, and, oh shoot, there was, you know, a number of other games that were mentioned along the way there. Legend of Dragoon, too. That one has a 100-day roll, which we can't get, so let's just head back for the tower for the time being. But, you know, I've got all these games that I really would love to play that I missed out on a long time ago. And, you know, it would please me for nothing more than just to play whatever I want and, like, churn these games out. But, just no dice. Oh, well. I'm still enjoying playing this one, though. But I do wish it was... I want to say I wish it was a little bit more linear, just because the G-Cal system was cool at first, but now it's starting to constrain me more than keep things interesting. And that's hurting it a little bit. I don't know. Oh well. We'll be done with this one soon. Let's figure out... It's probably going to just tell me to go to the mountain. And then we'll do an area change. And then actual story stuff will happen. We'll see. Okay, so... Now that we have the random... water for this dude. It should be, like, no issue. And then I'll probably come through on my own at some point and, I'll probably come through on my own at some point and, like, 100% all these maps. But that's for a different day. That's just straight up butt. Water, please, just a drop. We have no other leads. Get him some water, 100 Knight. Water jar. Water jar has been lost. No. Thank you so much. Thank you, really. You saved my life. But we can't stay here. The Sand Eater will take notice. It's already consumed my sheep. Huh? Sand Eater? Is that some kind of magic beast that lives in the area? It's dangerous here. I want to thank you, so please come visit our humble village. Tatara Village can be accessed via a pathway only us villagers know. Please come with me. A village in the desert? Sounds annoying, but who knows? The bell plant could be there. That is one sassy-ass stride. Oh, there we go. Oh, person has a human face. Weird. This way, please. If we are separated, please use the sound of my horn to guide you back to my side. So I gotta follow around Captain Horn Farts, and we'll get there. Gotcha. Remember the sound. Now then, let's go before the Sand Eater notices us. Hurry, hurry. I'm a little disappointed that it's just a basic, like, humanoid face. What? That is non-stop. Jesus Christ. Christ, it is just burp. It's like a car alarm. And a bad one at that. Or somebody's really been laying the Chipotle on thick. Looks to be a young girl, stank. But it could be a male. There might be male characters in this game. I'm gonna just ignore these things. Why are we taking, like, a crazy roundabout route here? Oh, you guys ain't escaping. There we go. See, no escape. Just death. Death for me. Death to appease me. God, that is so obnoxious. Maybe I didn't follow it properly. Maybe I have to get inside this wall. It looks like it, so he's on the other side, but we have to get inside the wall somewhere. Glorious. Okay. Well, this is obnoxious. And very annoying to listen to, mind you. Well. Actually, this is really easy. Why didn't you open the gate for me, you dingus? Alright, whatever. That is... Whomever designed this definitely didn't think about how annoying these kinds of things can be. It's just... I don't know. Sound effect design is hard to do. And, like, having it from, like, a plot perspective of, like, follow the sound of my voice, it's like, oh, I don't want to. I mean, if it's, like, an occasional thing, yeah, like, count me in. Like, that shit can be really cool and interesting. Or it can be incredibly, incredibly repetitive. To the point of being, like... Oh, this is awful. Alright, whatever. We're almost done. I totally could have found my way here on my own. I also, trying to follow the sound here seems, like, meaningless. I can't do it. This way. Motherfucker. This is, like, back the way we came. At least I've got, like, a fair amount of grade here, and there's also, like, zero enemies to fight the entire way. I think that's my problem with this area. It's just so much, like, running and so little anything else. That it's just like, well, I'm probably gonna have to backtrack here. I honestly can't tell where the noise is coming from. Have to backtrack here. But, you know, I'm so used to very enemy-dense areas that... It's not, The hell? Are they scared of something? Shh. Hold on, there's something moving around underneath you. Sand eater. That twitching animation is kind of goofy. Huh, I see. That's the sand eater. Seems stronger than I thought. Since it makes the desert beast its prey, something of average strength can't hope to fight it. For whatever reason, it just completely ignored you. Huh. Magic beings have no nourishing substances, after all. Good, we're safe. We're almost there, just a bit more now. Okay. What? Chest inside this. Of course. I was like, why is there just like a random destructible thing here? Why am I even... I probably should have done this later, but we're here. At least my stomach capacity is getting larger. Oh, hey, it's one of these guys. I'll give him a wide berth for a second. Get that thing open. Though, honestly, we don't need any more... We got what? We didn't even get hit by the swinging tail. He just kind of. Wow. The hitbox on that is bullshit. I just bumped into a dead scorpion and took 60 damage. That's goofy. Another one of these where I don't know how to get across. Well, this probably isn't going to do it for me. So let's go back this direction. Maybe there's a bridge or something I missed along the way here. If I have to eat 100 roll, I'll do it. So I've not seen hair nor hide of... This is the most stupidly convoluted segment. Why make me do this? Okay. Well, unless it's like there's a secret bridge at the very, very tippy top of that. I guess we loop around or something. You can actually see the clouds popping in with the camera limitations. That's weird. At least we got a pillar up ahead. So I guess we know we're going on the right direction here. It's just the tedium of following a character is like, don't wanna. Especially Captain Tootie McTooterson. I don't know. Not exactly what I call good design here. Well, we'll be done soon, I hope. Either that or it turns out we're completely lost and stuck, and this is not. Sorry? Complete dead end. Oh, here we go. Not complete dead end. Turns out pathway here. Okay, that's useful. You can actually hear the reverberation in some of these. Wow. I don't have words apart from just like consistent disappointment. Oh, I found it. Well, this is a first. Did think the dude would warn me that he's got a cave shortcut here. It's like, follow my horn to the cave that I'm not going to tell you about. Follow the secret passageway, you'll get here eventually. It's like, this is the worst guide ever. Just fast travel me to your dumbass village or something. Instead, it's like the reversed escort quest from... I can hear him. I can literally hear him burping here. This is... goofy. At least, like, we're right here now. Let's get that pillar, seeing as we're starting to get into the danger zone. Though I think we might finally be here. Thank you so much for your help. We've made it to my village. As thanks for rescuing me, please come to my house. We'll prepare a delicious meal for you. I live in the village suburbs. I'll go ahead and start cooking. Huh? So this is what makes up a Beastman's village. Huh, somewhere nearby, I can sense a pillar, but I can't pinpoint it. They're always invisible, but I've always been able to figure out where they are before, so why now? Shh, whatever. Search the village for a bit. Alternatively, I think we're gonna have to leave the area just because I do not have enough G-Cal for this. Well, that's okay. Let's go back out. Let's go back to base, and let's manage some things.